everyone. I'm Dr. Kalyan. I'm a neurosurgeon and spine surgeon from Hyderabad. Welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I will explain you how do I operate upon a brain tumor. Brain tumor is a serious condition. So, as a neurosurgeon, this is my day in and day out job that I remove a brain tumor. So in this video, I will explain you how exactly I remove a brain tumor in a simple language using the help of pictures and images which you can understand. So first, how do I diagnose a brain tumor? When I see a patient, when I have a suspicion of brain tumor, the investigation of choice for me is an MRI or a magnetic resonance imaging. So when I do a magnetic resonance imaging, or which is commonly called as an MRI, it usually diagnoses a brain tumor. So in this picture,
once the doctor suspects brain tumor, the next step is confirming whether the patient actually has a brain tumor or not. For confirming it, the most common and the investigation of choice is MRI of brain without contrast. This is one MRI picture of my patient, which shows MRI of brain with contrast. This white structure which is seen in the MRI of brain is the brain tumor. So now let's come to the actual procedure which is done. So patient is given general anesthesia. After giving general anesthesia and the patient becomes conscious, the first step involves raising the skin flap. So the surgeon starts taking a skin flap. In taking the skin flap, the surgeon correlates the MRI finding. It correlates the location of the tumor on the MRI and takes an appropriate skin flap exactly overlying the brain tumor. The skin flap is completed. After completing the skin flap, the skin flap is elevated forward. Once the skin flap is elevated, what you are seeing here, this is all the skull bone. The next step, the second step involves removing the skull bone. As you all know, the skull bone is a very strong structure. It's a very strong bone. So to remove the skull bone, as a surgeon, I use special instruments which make holes within the skull bone. These holes are called burrholes in the medical language. So in this picture, this is first burrhole, this is the second one, and this is the third one. The number of burrholes and the location of burrholes depends upon the location of the tumor, which the surgeon has already assessed using the MRI of the brain. Once the holes are made, the surgeon uses a specialized instrument to connect the burrholes and making it a bone flap and detaching it from the surrounding skull. Once the bone flap is separated from the surrounding skull, it is removed. So in this picture, this is the bone flap. It is being removed out. Once the bone flap is removed, what you are seeing below my cursor is a white glistening tough layer which is known as a dura mater. The dura mater protects the normal brain. In this step, I take an incision over the dura mater and elevate it. So this is incision of the dura mater and I'm elevating the dura mater. So once I elevate the dura mater, what I am seeing is the normal brain. So this is the normal brain. And because I have localized the brain tumor on the MRI and have taken the bone flap over the tumor, so this is our brain tumor. So what you are seeing here is the brain tumor. Now the actual step starts, removal of the brain tumor. Before I tell you the next steps, I want you to introduce an important equipment which is useful for me. This is known as a operating microscope. As you all know, the brain is a very delicate structure. The nerves and the blood vessels which supply these nerves are very small, very delicate, and they are of the size of microns. So for me to operate, I need to magnify these structures and see them under illumination with a lot of clarity. This purpose is fulfilled by this operating microscope. So, under the operating microscope, per tumor remover, in the first step, I remove the central portion of the tumor. This process is called debulking. So, as the tumor is debulked, it gets slightly separated from the neighboring brain. And we start developing a plane between the tumor and the brain parenchyma. Once I get that plane, I define the plane. I very gently separate the brain from the brain tumor. I use a number of instruments which are known as microsurgical instruments. These are some of the microsurgical instruments which you can see. Using them, I am separating the brain tumor from the normal brain. Once the separation is completed, I remove the brain tumor. This is after removing the brain tumor, you are seeing the normal brain. At this stage, I properly seal all the small blood vessels so that there is no further bleeding. My job of removing the brain tumor is done. So I need to close it back. So the final step is closure. And the steps here are exactly the reverse of the steps which I have done during opening. So I reflect the dura mater back and I suture it. I replace the skull bone and anchor it to the surrounding skull using titanium clips, plates, or sometimes I simply use the sutures. I replace this skin flap back and suture it. So this completes my surgery for a brain tumor. Then the anesthetist slowly and carefully reverses the patient back from anesthesia. And then as a neurosurgeon, I check the patient for any neurological deficits. And once the patient is fine, the patient is shifted into the recovery room.
So after seeing this video, I hope you have understood how a brain tumor is removed. The success of the surgery depends upon a number of factors. It depends upon the neurological status of the patient, the nature of the brain tumor, how soft it is, how blood it is, how we call it vascularity, how much blood supply the tumor it has, which part of the brain it is, how deep it is from the surface of the brain, in which part of the brain it is located, and many factors. And also one of the most important factor is the experience of the surgeon, and as I've told you, the microscope. So I hope you have understood how a brain tumor is removed, and I hope you will take a proper decision to get it operated. So if you have liked my video, do subscribe and do like my channel. And I have told in my prior videos, in my subsequent videos, I will be explaining you a number of disorders in the brain, what are the symptoms, how to identify them, how to treat them. So if you want to have an early update on my future videos, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And if you have any other queries and want to contact me, you can contact me on my WhatsApp number. Thank you.